हेलो, माय नेम इज़ वेदांत। आई एम एन लीगल इंटर्न विथ लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस वीडियो आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट प्लीज़ लाइक एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो एंड सब्सक्राइब टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी। आई वांट टू आल्सो गिव अ डिस्क्लेमर दैट दिस वीडियो डज नॉट प्रमोट और एडवर्टाइज एनीथिंग अबाउट द कंपनी एज पर द BCI गाइडलाइन एंड दिस वीडियोज आर ओनली फॉर एजुकेशनल पर्पसेज। सो for the today's video is about enforcement of arbitral awards in India, how the awards can be enforced, whether domestic awards or a foreign awards in India. Arbitration is the most effective and dominant form of or method of as alternate dispute resolution compared to conciliation, mediation, negotiation, etc. Arbitration as an alternate dispute resolution is usually used in resolving disputes, particularly in international commercial transactions conducted across national boundaries as well as in domestic transactions that are civil in nature. It can also be used in matters of employment or consumer disputes. So arbitration as an important alternate dispute resolution, how an award is enforced, an arbitral award can be enforced in India. The regulation and execution of decrees in India is governed by the Code of Civil Procedure, while the arbitral award procedure and enforcement is governed by the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996 and the CPC also. For in the same way, an Indian court executes a decree or enforces a decree, arbitral award can also be enforced in the an arbitral award can also be enforced in India according to the depending can also be enforced in India. However, there is a difference depending on the seat of arbitration. Seated arbitral awards, that is domestic award, would be governed by part 1 of the act, and enforcement of foreign seated arbitral awards are governed by part 2 of the act. So first, enforcement of domestic arbitral awards. Until filing for compliance and execution, an award recipient would have to wait for 90 days after receiving the award. The award may be questioned during this transitional period in compliance with section 34 of the act. When the above time expires, if a court considers that the award enforceable at the execution point, the authenticity of the arbitral award cannot be questioned any further. Before the recent Arbitration and Conciliation Amendment Act 2015, a petition to set aside an award could equate to a stay in the award execution proceeding. Nevertheless, a party opposing an award would have to consider a separate application to demand a stay on an award by virtue of the recent Amendment Act of 2015. Second, enforcement of foreign arbitral awards. India is a sovereign country and is a signatory to Geneva Convention on the Execution of Foreign Arbitral Awards 1927 and Convention on the Recognition of Foreign and Recognition and Enforcement of Foreign Arbitral Award 1958 New York Convention. If a party receives a binding award from a state signing signatory of the New York Convention or the Geneva Convention, and the award is made in territory recognized by India as a convention country, the award would then be enforceable in India. In India, implementing a foreign award is a two-stage procedure, beginning by filing a request for execution. Initially, a judge will decide if the award met the criteria set out by the law. Once the award has been considered enforceable, it can be applied as a court order. At this point, however, parties should be aware of the various obstacles that may occur, such as frivolous complaints from the opposing power side, and the provisions such as bringing the award's original or authenticated copy and the underlying agreement before the court. So, what are the conditions for enforcement of award, foreign as well as domestic? A party may use the following grounds to contest an award. If the other party shows this, such award would be made unenforceable or would not be enforceable. First, according to the statute, that is the act, the parties fit to the settlement for under any disability. Second, the agreement in question did not comply with the law to which the parties are subject or with the law of the country in which the award was made. Third, the party did not receive a proper notice of appointment from the arbitrator or the arbitral proceeding, or otherwise unable to bring his or her case before the arbitral tribunal. Fourth, the award deals with distinction that the award does not fall within the terms of the agreement. Fifth, award contains decision on matters beyond the scope of being referred for arbitration, that is the award, that is the matters which are not arbitrable. Sixth, the arbitral proceedings did not comply with the agreement. Seventh, the composition of the arbitral body or the arbitral proceeding does not comply with the law of the country in which the arbitration took place. Eighth, the party, precisely a foreign award, the award precisely a foreign award, was not binding on the parties or was set aside or revoked by a competent authority of the state in which the award was made by the statute of which it was made. Under Indian law, or ninth, under Indian law, the statute, the subject matter of the dispute cannot be resolved by arbitration. Enforcing the award would be contradictory to India's public policy. So this was all about how an arbitral award can be enforced in India, whether it is a domestic award or it is a foreign, or it is a foreign seated arbitral award, and what are the conditions that needs to be satisfied before enforcement of such award. Do like and share this video and subscribe to the YouTube channel of Flexus and Company. Thank you.